हाय अक्षिता, वेलकम। हाउ
हेलो, हाय. आई
आर यू?
एम गुड, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम गुड, थैंक यू। और सिद्धक आल्सो जॉइंड योर क्लासमेट। ओके, वी विल वेट फॉर 2 मिनट्स एंड वी विल स्टार्ट एग्जैक्टली एट 11, लाइक आईएससी एंड 2:30, या
श्योर.
1:30,
ओके
सॉरी।
ओके
या सो यू आर इन लाइक होम क्वारंटीन, राइट? और लाइक यू आर टोटली एग्जेम्प्टेड राइट नाउ?
No, I'm at home. I didn't have to quarantine.
Okay, so basically you got the RT-PCR done at Toronto Airport, right?
No, actually, I was fully vaccinated, so
No
they
one.
didn't ask me. But when I was leaving the airport, so
Okay.
they gave me an at home RT-PCR kit.
Self testing kit. Okay, so you might be
Yeah.
having a pop up at a right can. Good.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, let's start then. So, hi guys, this is live regarding Doha route, and this was okay. One question: do you book the entire the whole itinerary was booked through you, or any agent was involved in this?
I booked it through an agent.
Oh, okay, perfect. Okay, can we have the whole experience from India to Doha and from Doha to Toronto? I'll turn off my mic now.
Yeah, sure. So, my case was actually a little complicated because my visa was going to expire in this month itself, so by the end of this month. And
July. Okay.
I was in India. And I had a return ticket, but it got cancelled because the direct flights got cancelled and everything. So, and then I was told that I would not be able to go back and stuff by some people. But then, so I.
Okay. Perfect. So basically, you flew from Ahmedabad or Mumbai or Delhi?
I'm actually from Baroda.
Okay.
So,
Your flight.
yeah, so I'm.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Your flight was from?
It was from Mumbai.
Mumbai, cool. Okay.
Yeah.
And what exactly was the cost of the whole package from India to Toronto?
It was around 1.6 or 7.
1.6. And okay, we
yeah.
have this question called, there's an application called ETRAS, right? In Etihad.
Yeah. Yeah,
sorry,
yeah.
In Doha. So, can you please explain something about how to fill the data in that? Is it complicated or simple?
The thing is that you have to do it after you get your COVID-19 negative report from here. So, like maybe 12 hours before your departure, it's good to do that. Because in so on the first, you have to fill out an application. On their website. So it is something etras.gov.qa, something like that. You have to go on that website and then you have to fill in your information. They ask for the purpose of your visit and etc. So you have to mention that it is for visiting purpose and not the residence purpose. There are two options. And then you have to upload your documents. It includes your passport copy, your visa,
vaccination also,
the visa copy, yeah, the vaccination certificates if you are vaccinated, and the negative COVID report, and your hotel booking at Qatar, Doha,
okay,
whatever your
how
destination
much
is.
Okay, I just got a like a post in one of the groups that 10 days hotel booking is compulsory now. Is it so,
No,
or
it's
like one
nothing
or two
like
days is
that.
also work? Nothing like
No,
that.
no, no, it's nothing like that. You just have to book for the number of days that you're sure you'll get your RT-PCR test back, the result of that. So,
Okay, perfect.
A couple of days is fine.
Okay, and is it also the thing that you have to carry Qatar Riyal, the currency of Qatar? Like how much money did you carry? Or no?
No, I didn't carry anything because I had my credit card from here. I have in Scotiabank, so it works globally. And apart from that, I also had a Forex card, so that worked. But you don't really have to carry currency if you don't have to spend outside which I mean, it depends on person to person. For your personal expenses, you can carry it, but otherwise, officially, it's not really required.
Okay. Did you carry, like, did you have to buy any SIM card from that country? Because I just got a message that you need a SIM card of that particular country when you land there.
No,
Is it so?
you don't need it. No. If you don't, they ask every, just in India, we get the option of giving our email ID, but there they usually ask for the Qatar number. So if you don't have it, you can request them to give your email ID instead. For example, when I landed and when I was in the queue for my baggage collection, before they send you for the PCR test, they collect your information. So it they make you fill a form in which you have to write your passport number and you have to show them your vaccination certificate if you have any, or your negative COVID report, and they'll ask you for your Qatar number because they'll send the result of the report that the RT-PCR test that you give at the airport, the Qatar airport, on the number. So if you don't have it, then you give them your email ID. If you have, so for example, my agent in Qatar had a Qatar number, so I gave his number. Otherwise, I would have given my email ID. So the lady beside me gave her email ID, so it worked as well. So it doesn't matter, just give your email ID.
We
And
have a question from
then,
Shweta. She says that is there any compulsory on arrival RT-PCR test as well as antibody test?
yes.
Both?
No, there's no antibody test, but the on arrival RT-PCR test is compulsory. They'll send you no matter what. And when you are in the queue for your baggage collection, and the charge is 300 Qatar riyal, so it is around 100 Canadian dollars. So you
almost a
can
thousand
pay
rupees.
it. Yeah, if you have currency, I mean, if you have cash, you give them cash, the Qatar currency cash, or you pay by card, up to you, Forex card.
Okay, now the
And
biggest
then,
question. Okay, please go ahead. Please,
yeah.
sorry. Yeah, please go ahead. I'll ask.
The thing is that they don't give a printout of the report if you are COVID negative. So you can ask them if you want a COVID negative report in the certificate form. They'll just send you a text message if you're negative, and that result gets updated in the Etiraz application.
Perfect, got it. So basically that works
Yeah.
in Canadian immigration as well, right? CBSA doesn't mind that. Soft copy.
Canadian immigration, they don't see the Etiraz application at all. You can ju it's just as good as uninstalling the application as soon as you leave Qatar, so it
Okay,
doesn't
got it.
matter.
Okay,
For
got it.
Canadian immigration, Arrive Can is compulsory.
Yeah, arrive scan is compulsory, correct.
Yeah.
Okay, now coming to the biggest question, return ticket, right?
Yeah.
As we have seen, Maldives, that's a different scene because that's something out of the air bubble. Now coming to Doha, did they ask any return ticket from you? Because Qatar Airlines still mentions on their website that you need the return ticket that I have also uploaded on the page. So were you asked about the return ticket?
No, I wasn't asked for it because before you go for your no, sorry. I mean, during check-in, they ask for all that stuff. They ask for the acceptance letter that you receive after your Etiraz application from the Qatar government, and they didn't ask for a return ticket. And because your final destination is Canada, you can just clearly tell them that I'm going to Canada and I don't need a return ticket. You shouldn't lie about it. There's no
Correct.
issue.
Okay,
Yeah.
but now I think they have implemented this thing because of two things. They claim that it's due to air bubble policy and the
I see.
marketing. It's basically the marketing policy because they will get money and later on when you will refund the money, like they will refund the money, it's like taxes will be given to them. Anyways, now return ticket. I'll just elaborate on this point. Was the return ticket asked in India as well or just in? Okay, definitely it was not asked from you, but in India, how was the immigration?
It was pretty smooth. Again, I was told by my travel agent that you should lie that you're going to come back and stuff from Qatar, that you're just going for visiting purposes. But I advise my consultant, actually Santosh sir from FutureLink Consultants, and he told me not to lie about anything and just tell them what it is. And that's what I did. So I just told them. So they ask you what is your final destination, etc. So I just told them that it's Canada and I'm going through Doha. And since I had a visa that was going to expire this month, so they told me that my visa is going to expire and everything, and I said that I'm aware about it and I'm on a postgraduate work permit. So they just asked me what did I study there and if I'm returning. So I said that yeah, I'm returning. I was there before, and they checked my study permit, they saw my visa, and then they just let me go. That's all they did. And I went from Mumbai airport. I don't know about other airports, but at Mumbai airport, that's all they did. And don't use your phone when you're there. They'll get mad. And
at
they,
the
when
Mumbai airport?
And then, yeah. I mean, when you're for the immigration, when you're there for the immigration, in front of the officer,
they
don't
mind
use
that.
Your phone.
This, obviously, you do not use
and
the
they're
cell phone.
Anyway, they're anyway pretty angry. They so just
that's
be
a job.
Polite and say thank you and sorry for everything.
Okay, perfect, perfect. Okay, I'm just going through the questions that I have. Okay, I have seen that the staff is not updated. The airline staff is not updated, but immigration, obviously, they are updated. Was that the thing that was felt by you as well? Like airline staff is staff was not updated about the rules, but immigration was. Was it the thing?
In India, I didn't face that because the staff did not really ask me anything. Uh-huh. When I was in Doha, when I was going to fly from Doha, during check-in, the Air India crew, they're pretty updated. They know everything. And when I was going to check-in for my flight from Doha to Toronto, they saw everything during check-in. So they asked for my vaccination certificate. They asked for my negative report. They checked my visa. They checked my study permit. They also asked me that your permit is going to expire. You're not studying anymore. Then I explained to them as well that I'm on post-graduation work permit. That's all. They don't ask much.
Okay, the last question from my end. I should have asked this question in the beginning. What exactly is your status? Are you on study permit or a work permit now? And how did you travel? Like on study permit or on work permit?
So I was pretty confused about that as well. So Santosh sir from FutureLink explained to me that since my studies are over, the visa that I'm going to be using, my visa is valid till 31st July. So it basically acts as a TRV to enter the country.
Temporary resident visa.
So I'm not a student anymore. I'm on applied status, but since my visa is valid, I can enter the country and use it as a TRV.
Okay, perfect, perfect. Okay, I think from my end, questions are done. Anything that you would like to suggest the other students who will be flying soon? What do's and don'ts for this route?
Check your status well if you can actually fly or not. If you have a valid visa and study whatever kind of permit that you have, then just I would suggest that you consult a good consultant. Mine was FutureLink Consultants. They are both in India and Toronto, so with their help and
in touch with them. That's correct. Even I had a word with them in the morning.
So just because of their certainty I went, they have helped me with everything since 2019. So because of that only I had the courage to go, because I trust them. And apart from that, at Doha, check in advance how much time the clinic takes to give you the report. So I actually checked in my hotel on 20th night, and on 21st it was Eid there, so majority of the things were closed. But my flight was on 22nd. On 20th itself it was Eid, so and my flight was on 22nd. So I was concerned if I was going to get my report on time on 20th. But on the day of Eid itself, I asked my travel agent to get me an appointment, because I would just have one day with me. So the
Okay.
clinic that we went to, they took at least 24 to 36 hours to give you a report. So that is a matter of concern if you just have one day with you.
So
So I
basically,
would
we
say
should be
that
keeping
at
a time
least,
lapse of at least 48 hours, right? That's what you're suggesting?
yeah, just keep 2 days, I would say, the
Okay.
day that you get your test and the next day.
Okay.
That would be safe. And
Correct.
just check in advance what clinic takes how much ever time. Because
Okay.
if you don't get your report on time,
Would you like to recommend any clinic that was like quick to get the report?
The clinic that I went to was called, I don't remember the name
No worries. You
exactly.
can just let me know later. I'll
Yeah.
just add in the description. Okay. I think we are missing some questions in the comments. I did not see that. We'll just answer it quickly. Okay. From Bhat
Okay.
Shweta, we have, do we need to carry 500 Qatari with us?
No, no,
Let's
no.
look.
No, you
No.
don't.
Okay.
No.
COVID PCR result time taken. How much time was it? Did you get the result?
I gave my test around 4 p.m. on 20th, and I got the results at 6:30 p.m. on 21st. So it
Okay.
took a bit over 24 hours. So
Okay.
you should have at least that much
And the
time.
connecting flight from Doha to Toronto, was it direct or did it have any layover? I guess Frankfurt?
It was, for me, it was direct.
Direct?
It was
Oh, okay.
direct.
Cool. Which
Yeah.
airline was it?
It was Air Canada. 13 hours, it was a 13 hour journey.
Okay, perfect. And your total expenses were 1.16?
Yeah,
No.
around that
Perfect.
much.
So let's wrap it up. Thank you so much. I guess anything, if you would like to say anything, then bye.
That's all I think. On Canadian immigration as well, don't lie about anything, I would say.
Yes,
They
obviously,
let you
CBSA
go.
knows everything.
Yeah.
Correct, CBSA knows
Just
everything.
don't be smart with them. They know everything. Just be
I know
honest,
the
and
other
if you
partner of
have
mine.
everything, be confident.
Yeah, correct. I'll just tell you this incident. The other partner of mine, Amit, he just told the address of like, okay, I'll be staying at this in Brampton. They just tied and
Yeah.
they showed him the rooms of that. Okay, this is your property where you'll be in quarantine. It happened like 2 months ago. So they're very
Yeah.
smart, obviously. Okay, how you get the hard copy of COVID certificate, I'll explain that to you on call. We are already connected on WhatsApp. 500 Qatar currency rule was implemented yesterday night. Okay, this rule, obviously, it was implemented yesterday night. So you must not be aware about this, Akshata. So we'll just
Yeah,
have someone else
the
who's
hard
assigned.
copy you can collect from the clinic itself. One thing, they don't give a copy with QR code. They stamp it instead. So the stamp is as good as the QR code.
Yeah, that
So
is valid,
you can
correct.
rely on it. And they won't send the copy on email. You have to go and collect the physical copy.
Okay. And if we provide our email
Yeah.
ID, then they provide on email or not? Or do we
No,
have to
I
request?
requested a lot, but they only give original copy, stamped copy. They don't give
Okay,
it on
that will
email.
also work. That will work. What
Yeah.
time is posted sample taking time or sample report result time on the report?
I think the result is important.
Okay, no, time is not important. Okay.
Yeah.
Any questioning at Canadian immigration? Obviously, you were a returning student, so I don't think anything would be.
No,
But yeah.
they didn't ask anything. They just asked me that if I'm aware that my study permit is going to expire soon. So I said that I know it and I'm on post-graduation work permit. They asked for the letter, my application letter, and they asked me what was my duration of stay in India and why was I there for so long. So I explained to them that my ticket got cancelled. I had a return ticket, and
Okay.
then they
And
asked me where I'm going to stay. I just told them that I'm going to stay with my flatmate, and they didn't ask me anything else
Yes, you
after
already have
that.
a
And
private
they,
room, correct.
yeah, they put a
And
green sticker on my passport.
which had
So,
TSAC written on it?
yes, so that means that you're fully vaccinated. And
Yes, correct.
when you go ahead, they'll just ask you to show your passport. So just to show the cover of it, on the side they put this sticker, and on the basis of that, they let you go.
Okay. This question coming. How was the hotel in Doha? It was good. Obviously, it should be. So,
Yeah, it was okay. It was
what
good.
about the baggages and weight luggage? How much did you carry? This question was missing.
Yeah, so for Qatar, I was allowed 30 kgs plus 7 kgs for cabin. So I had two bags with me actually, and my weight was actually less than 22 kgs in one bag, and my cabin bag had 7 kgs. So for Qatar, it was smooth. In Canada, in Air Canada, I was allowed 2 bags of 23 kgs each for luggage and one cabin bag of 7 kgs. So,
okay. Perfect. I think we are done with all the questions, and that was, I guess, the most, like, very smooth experience, right?
Yeah, it was super smooth, and they don't trouble you at all. At Qatar, they don't trouble you.
Okay, perfect. Okay, this is actually, okay, last question, please, no more questions after this. First, we need to do RT-PCR on airport and then again while returning to Canada. Is it so? Like, 2 RT-PCRs?
You should do it just in case they don't provide you a certificate. So for me, they just sent me a text message. You should ask them. I didn't ask for it because my next COVID test was already booked. So I didn't ask for a certificate, and I didn't know that they will not provide me a certificate. I was of the assumption that they might send me an email or something, but they just send you a message that your result is negative, and that later automatically reflects on the Etaraz app. So I think it's for their own purpose. But if you request, probably they will provide a certificate. I'm not sure about it. So someone should, whoever is traveling, they should call and ask if they'll provide a certificate.
Okay, perfect. Okay, Shweta, please text me, text us on this Instagram page. We'll provide you the document that is required for the quarantine that has all the rules written on it. So yeah, thank you so much, Akshata. I guess Siddhak has this question. Your classmate, so we'll keep him on the VIP list. I heard they deported 17 people today. Is it true? I don't know.
How can I tell? I mean, they didn't. They will deport you if you have a positive COVID test. So yeah, this thing happened that people coming from India, they show a fake RT-PCR report that they're negative. And when you come at the Qatar airport, they take the test and then you can't fake it. They'll know what's the result. And they give the result within a couple of hours, very quickly. So they'll just deport you right away if you're positive.
I have this question. Even I'm quite inquisitive about this. People who were fully vaccinated, were they also found positive?
I'm not sure about that. I don't know.
Okay, no problem. Fine. Thank you so much for your time, Akshita. That was a great experience that you shared. And Ankit, do we have your consent? Can we share it among the masses as well in the group, this video?
Sure. Yes,
okay,
sure.
Thank you so much for your time. Have a good night. Good day. You are
no
in Canada.
Yeah.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Swastik, big fan.